Richmond Hill.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Canada's military is in crisis on this defense minister's watch. An institution that has been revered for over 100 years, Canada's military has liberated occupied nations, fought for democracy, freedom, and peace, and brought honor and respect to our country and Canadian citizens. And now it's facing some of the darkest days in its history. Canada's military is entrusted with protecting and preserving Canadian values, but it must also embody them. However, serious abuse of power, sexual misconduct, and discrimination at the highest levels in Canada's military continues unchecked. And this defense minister and the prime minister have failed to act. That's why today's Opposition Day motion calls on the House of Commons to censure the Minister of Defense and why it's so important. Members of the government will cry that today's motion amounts to nothing more than petty partisan politics, and that in itself is evidence that this government neither understands its sworn obligation nor the dire situation that Canada's military is in. Members of a parliament are elected to govern. And governing is much more than merely passing laws. Governing, at its most fundamental, is about ensuring that those entrusted with leading the country embody the values of honesty and integrity that Canadians expect, and to hold them to account when they have broken that most sacred trust. In his direction to ministers in 2015, this prime minister charged them with creating the culture of integrity and accountability that allows them to earn and keep the trust of Canadians. The prime minister went on to say that whether a minister has discharged responsibilities appropriately is a matter of political judgment by Parliament. Therefore, any attempt to characterize today's Opposition Day motion as partisan or petty politics must be vehemently rejected. It is the role of Parliament to judge a minister, and not one we take lightly. Today, this House of Commons is fulfilling that most difficult and serious responsibility. This defense minister has not acted with integrity and accountability. Instead, he has consistently misrepresented the facts, refused to answer direct questions, failed to implement important changes to improve the military's culture, and turned a blind eye to serious allegations. In 2018, allegations of serious misconduct were made against the former chief of the defense staff, General Vance. For 3 years, this defense minister knew, and key officials in the Prime Minister's office, the Privy Council, and the Minister's office knew, and they all did nothing. And no one would have known if two parliamentary committees, the Defence Committee and the Status of Women Committee, hadn't decided to study these serious military misconduct. And what Canadians have learned through the testimony at those committees and in the media has simply shaken us to our core. Hours and hours of jarring testimony detailing accounts of abuse of power, misogyny, rape, sexual harassment, and discrimination. We heard, and what Canadians have learned through the testimony at those committees and in the media has simply shaken us to our core. Hours and hours of jarring testimony detailing accounts of abuse of power, misogyny, rape, sexual harassment, and discrimination. We heard testimony of investigations that were never carried out or covered up, evidence that was lost or tampered with, serious crimes that were pleaded down to administrative slaps on the wrists, purged from the records, and simply forgotten. We heard from victims who were threatened into silence and themselves blamed for what had happened to them. They told us how their careers were destroyed and they were drummed out of the military. And perhaps most tragically, we heard from victims who believe that they will never be able to get justice for what happened to them. To quote retired Colonel Bernie Boland, the entire institutional weight, influence, power, intellect, and knowledge is directed against victims rather than what it's purportedly supposed to be. Equal justice for all is not being applied here at all. All of this in Canada's military? How could this possibly happen in a country like Canada where justice, accountability, and the rule of law are our foundation? The former chief of the defense staff, the highest military officer, then his replacement, Admiral McDonnell, General Vance, Admiral Edmondson, General Fortin, General Rouleau, Admiral Baines are all either under police investigation or have had to step aside for questionable conduct. Even more, general and flag officers are complicit through their actions or their silence. The failure of Canada's military starts at the top of the chain of the command, and the top is this defense minister. Under the National Defense Act, the defense minister is responsible for the management and direction of the Canadian force, and it's his duty to hold those at the most senior levels to the highest standards. A military has great power. It is the one group of people in Canadian society entrusted with the ability to bear arms and to commit acts of violence on behalf of the country. And in a democracy, citizens need to know that the military is held in check by our elected officials. The minister had a responsibility to take swift and immediate action regarding the allegations against Vance, but for 3 years he did nothing. And while he may not have conducted the investigation himself, it was up to him to ensure one was done. As elected officials, our loyalty is to country first, before party, before individuals. We are here to act in the best interest of the country. That's what we also ask of our military, and Lieutenant Commander Trotter risked his personal well-being to do what is right. In his words, he said, "As an officer in the Canadian Armed Forces, I swore an oath to Queen and country to fulfill my duties, and there's the old adage of service before self. There may be blowback, there may be career implications, but my personal conviction as an officer in the Canadian Armed Forces is to put the service and my service members above my own needs and safety. Canadians rely on ministers to do the same and to put this country and Parliament before themselves and to accept responsibility when they failed to do so. But after months of questions in the House and numerous appearances at committee, not once has this defense minister accepted any responsibility. Not once has he said he should have done something differently. And most importantly, not once has he committed to holding anyone accountable who have failed in their duty. Lasting change will only come when those who have failed are held accountable. And governing doesn't mean delegate and disappear. It means ensuring that government departments and public servants deliver the services Canadians need to the standards they expect in a manner that brings honor and pride to Canada as a nation. And when it comes to ensuring the conduct of the highest level of the Canadian Armed Forces, the Defence Minister and Prime Minister say it's not up to them. If the Defence Minister and the Prime Minister are not responsible, then who is? The Defence Minister has clearly shown he won't accept responsibility, he won't act honourably, admit he's failed in his duties, and resign. And the Prime Minister will not hold him accountable and fire him. Rather than standing for women, the Prime Minister has reinforced an entrenched and toxic military culture. His inaction has emboldened the old boys' club and denied women the opportunity to be believed. Women in the military have earned the right to serve equally with respect. All men and women in uniform have sworn to give their lives for their country. In return, their elected officials must vigorously ensure they too are protected by Canadian values. Service to country is who I am at my core. My father was a major general, and he served in the military. I followed him, like many others, in uniform, and was honored to wear the Canadian flag on my sleeve. This defense minister has lost the trust and confidence of military and Canadians. The crisis in Canada's military will not end until this defense minister is censured. I implore all of my colleagues in this House to support this motion and censure the defense minister. Thank you.